Thank you. much indulge.
I'm here to take a short vacation, and I wish you wouldn't shout.
I will be hurt.
Not one more word.
Procrastination is upset. All I said is, some other time, not now, not now, not now, not now. Later perhaps I may demand to know just how we stand.
Off of this not now business indefinitely. No, no, no. I've asked for an explanation, and an explanation I mean to have.
I've already given you my explanation.
And I find it incredible, inconsequential, inconsequent, inconsistent with the facts.
And I find you an incompoop. The explanation I've given you is the only one you're ever likely to get. In any case, the alleged incident happened over a week ago, and I claim the statute of limitations.
That's bad law.
But good sense. Quarrels should be wound up at the end of the week like 8-day clocks.
Oh, and that's nonsense. 8-day clocks haven't been invented yet.
King Menelaus.
Madam.
I came to Nauplia for a little peace and quiet. The idea was to try and forget.
Ah, forget what? Again, those dark hints.
And it was not part of my plan that every time I strolled forth to court the sea breeze, I should have to put up with you courting it with me. So kindly stop following me around. And thank your stars that so far I've given you nothing more to complain of than a dream.
Well, well, well. Oh, monkey. She's in what you might call a bit of a huff, isn't she? Still, never mind, eh?
Young man, I'm liable to run amok at a moment's notice.
I've got a better idea. Why not stay here with us and watch the local devotees of Tipsickery perform a ballet? They guarantee to calm the nerves and soothe the equilibrium by the sheer poetry of motion. So, on with the nymphs, sylphs, naiads and dryads. After all, Nunky, we are here to enjoy ourselves.
Thank you.
Heavy astrological equipment with me. I just have a do-it-yourself kit. But the signs and portents, so far as I can interpret them, do tend to indicate an interesting day.
Thank you, Calchas.
In fact, you might have a certain amount of excitement. I can positively guarantee it because I've arranged it. Just wait here a minute.
I wasn't going to keep my word.
I hoped you weren't going to try. Seeing you again isn't going to help me to forget.
Do you really think you'll be able to do that? Ever? Do you think either of us could possibly?
I keep pretending, hoping we might. Because we must. You're Paris of Troy. I'm Helen of Sparta. We live separate lives in different worlds. We met. We loved. Parted. That's the end of the story, isn't it?
And what happens to our dream of love?
That's all it was. All it can ever be.
A dream of love so sweetly fulfilling, yearnings and longings we know are in vain. Two dreams of love so tender.
Suppose I were to tell you it needn't only be a dream. Helen, Calchas, and I have a wonderful plan all worked out. We can go into action and you'll be mine forever. You only have to say the word.
What? Then quick, tell me what the word is and I'll say it.
You have. Leave everything to me, and I promise you.
The dream of love we two have been sharing blindly, unheeding the world that we knew. Enwrapped and trance for love alone caring, now you are daring to say, shall clouds drop?
Where are you going?
Into action. Oh, don't worry if I look a little different next time you see me. It'll still be me. And you know me, don't you?
Better make it by snappy, my boy. Those two half-wit heroes are coming. Best of luck. I'll see you later. Fair Queen, let us continue our promenade as if nothing had happened and accept my assurances that a great deal more is going to. As I was saying, I have difficulty with a long-range forecast without my astrological computer, but the signs, as far as I can see them, do tend to indicate fair wind.
I don't think much of this incognito bit, do you, Achilles?
Agamemnon says everyone needs a change, even royalty. He says it's good for us to escape attention now and again by looking quite ordinary.
I know. Mingling unnoticed in the motley throng.
Actually, I feel more conspicuous than usual.
I feel like an idiot.
Do you like being on holiday? I mean, are you enjoying yourself?
Not a lot. You know, all of this relaxing makes my muscles flabby.
Didn't you go swimming this morning?
Oh,
water looked too cold. Didn't you?
You know very well I can't walk on pebbles with my gammy heel.
You know, if we told the truth about it, we're both a bit fed up. There's no one to have a go at. Say, if only that young fellow Paris would have the nerve to pinch Helen from old man Menelaus. Wouldn't that be a lovely excuse for a Trojan War?
It certainly would.
Pity we don't know where he is. We could give him a little hint.
Probably doesn't want to war. Too busy judging beauty competitions.
Trojans! You know, there's no two ways about it. Men with talents like ours are just wasted on piecework.
Very famous Grecian heroes.
The marks we got at school were zeros.
We could play Olympic games.
We love to hear the bugles blowing.
Oh, but the music hath such charm.
As they begin, we're waiting in.
We're waiting in and never feel the slightest qualms.
We know we'll win.
We know we'll win.
We always win.
We always win.
We are two mighty men at arms.
The might of Ajax is quite frightening.
Achilles calls for mercy scream.
And once he tried defying lightning,
his trouble is that he's a thief.
We join in any fight that's good.
We kept them kin, because we love wars alarm.
We fight to win,
we fight to win,
and always win,
and always win. We are two mighty men at arms.
We're part of Gorgias protectors against an ancient Trojan foe,
and with the Troiluses and if they behave, we must keep showing
what friendly people Greeks can be.
But if they don't,
we hope they won't.
We hope they won't.
There'll be a lovely scrap, you'll see.
We'll do them in.
Refusal to countenance the transfer of Helen's affections from yourself to this fellow Paris, you're flying in the face of Venus. And as you must know, the wrath of Venus could have disastrous results. You don't want our race to become extinct, do you?
You're not seriously suggesting that I should make a present to this whippersnapper of my wife?
Why not?
Divorce by divine decree doesn't involve any embarrassing disclosures. What's more, it saves expense.
Certain something will have to be done. We simply can't go on like this. Just think of all the matrimonial bliss
and all the fun and games we're missing. and why? 'Cause Venus is annoyed. Her plans you've rendered null and void.
She's filled with gruntled and frustrated.
So do we, and well we might.
She's simply got duplicated. Only you can put matters right.
Why, oh boy, am I so ill-fitted? What a terrible plan.
To face the facts, you have not yet begun yet to think of how unthinkable the risk we run. Something must be done. The right to survive, the fight must be won. Something must be done. Yes, something must. Yes, something must be done.
You have a chance to serve the nation. I know if I were in your shoes, I would react with jubilation. What has a husband got to lose? You have no choice. Your hand is forced. So just rejoice and get divorced. No more pain, far less strain. So I settle for a ball and chain. Once you're free, you'll agree it's a very happy thing to be.
No more pain, far less strain. So I settle for a ball and chain. Once you're free, you'll agree it's a very happy thing to be.
Pray say that you'll obey us.
I suppose so.
Oh Sparta, oh Sparta, dear country of the free. A life or a wife is not much to give for thee. A martyr for Sparta brings immortality. It's very, very necessary for posterity.
The future has to be protected. Things are bad as they can be. But I can hardly be expected to be glad, it's up to me. No wonder I'm a bit dejected.
Very sad, we do agree.
Very sad, yes, we do agree. Things are very bad, bad as they can be. Oh, woe is me. A life for a wife is not much to give for thee. It's very, very necessary for posterity. And as a duty must be done, although it's true, it isn't fun. We three agree something must be done.
But damn it all, I don't want to divorce my wife.
What's that got to do with it? When the gods have set their heart on something, there's nothing to be done about it except bow to the inevitable with a good grace. Suppose they wanted my daughter as an offering. I'd say, take her, just like that.
Aha, but suppose they wanted your wife.
Ha ha, that old battle axe, I'd be delighted.
My wife doesn't happen to be a battle axe.
But she's quite as cutting, and nothing like as well-tempered. Can't think why you want to hang on to her the way she treats you.
No, it's true. Helen's a bit of a riddle, but not one I'm prepared to give up. There must be some other way out of this situation.
Well, what do you propose?
Well, Calchas, as a mighty ogre, you must have devised some stratagem.
Yes, briefly, sire. I've arranged for Venus's mightiest representative, or what you might call her chief ogre, to come from the island of Kythera and take fair Helen on a pilgrimage. Venus, having received the most dutiful offerings, will then clear up everything to everyone's satisfaction.
An excellent plan, and an ambitious one, if you can pull it off.
I have every confidence.
I'm surprised you're prepared to support a common market in oracle workers. I always thought augurs couldn't meet without bursting out laughing at one another.
It's a risk from which the cloth should normally be protected, but this is a special case.
Well, do you approve of our tactics?
For once, brother, you're actually being intelligent. When is this mighty chief augur of Venus to be expected?
He should be close at hand. I'd say that at any moment now we could...
Say, look at that. Everybody, come and have a look. What a beauty. What all the excitement.
Somebody arriving now by the look of it.
This could be the great man himself.
What's going on? What is it?
Greatest I've ever seen.
Jeddah himself?
Oh, come now.
Well, it looks like it's made out of coal.
Oh, no.
Yes.
Jupiter and Sparta, and welcome to the chief Tiborga of the Shrine of Venus on the island of Kythera.
From Menelaus, king of Sparta, all hail.
Agamemnon greets you on behalf of all the kings of Greece.
I thank you for your salutations on behalf of the goddess I serve, the incomparable Venus. But one greeting is missing, that of the fair Queen Helen.
Well, she's not with us just now. She's not in a very sociable mood at the moment.
We'll soon remedy that. I come here at Venus's command to take her on a little excursion to Kythera.
Ah, wonderful island, beautiful climate.
And there, at the shrine of the goddess, she shall receive from the oracle a panacea for all her ills, the solution to all her problems, and yours.
In return for a suitable offering?
Naturally. It will be a most rewarding pilgrimage.
Just the thing, an excellent idea.
Suppose the queen doesn't want to go.
Quiet, boy. The queen will be guided by her counselors, by her elders, and by this mighty ogre.
And this one, too.
The queen must do her duty. The ship will do her good. Hang it all, I was packed off to Crete. She might have been sent to the embassy in Riyadh.
Suppose she says she won't go.
I will insist.
To the Queen, Belle Helen, it'll be au revoir. If she's going sailing too far, give her up. But the Queen, Belle Helen, hasn't yet had a say. There's no way of telling if she will obey.
One who insists you take a trip to appease, if you please, the wrath of the goddess Venus.
Indeed! And who is telling Helen what she must do?
May I please explain?
He's very clever at explaining.
Pray let the man explain what Venus doth ordain.
Certain things must be made known to Helen alone. Oh, enchanting goddess of love, how often you give us mortals a glimpse of heaven above. Won't you take this chance that I bring and o'er the sea with me, take wing, take wing.
Yes, I'll do as you advise me.
A very proper thing to say.
The queen is acting very wisely.
This mighty ogre will obey.
I conscience guided, the queen has decided, and free for soul to trust.
Goodbye, my beautiful Helen, beautiful Helen, beautiful Helen, though we'll miss you so.
We know you want to go.
Farewell, Helen, be careful, Helen, be careful, Helen, be careful.
It's been touch and go.
May gentle breezes blow.
With a rather special entourage.
And though it's so unexpected, I'll be protected, not be neglected. Now I've been collected and the ogre's in charge.
My best endeavors I will employ. Be sure that Helen this trip will enjoy. With Paris to try.
Oh, would you believe it? Could you believe it? Should you believe it? Should you believe it? Oh, that naughty boy. Oh, that naughty boy. Taking our Helen, our fair Helen. We try. Oh, naughty, naughty boy. Naughty boy.
one.